What is going on, everybody? My name is ZBERRY, and welcome effing back to the channel. Welcome back to the Sim Rig. We are back on some NASCAR. I know, you're at a weird angle now. You're, like, up here. I actually don't think, before all my Elgato issues, I don't even think I was able to show the new steering wheel that I got. I ended up picking up a Fanatec CSL Elite. Really awesome wheelbase. This thing is super realistic, and it's a lot of fun. It's a whole lot better than the other Logitech G29 wheel that I started with. But yeah, we're back on some NASCAR. NASCAR Heat 5 came out since the hiatus. What we were doing before the whole issues that I was having was we were basically going every week and going over everything that happened in the races. Instead of going through and trying to play catch up, I'm just going to rattle off everybody that's won and give you a quick update and see how fast I can run through, you know, who's won what. And then we're going to pick up and we're going to go to Daytona is what we're going to do. So, without further ado, let's see how fast I can name off who has won what race. All right. So we came back to Darlington and Kevin Harvick won. Kevin Harvick won on a Saturday and then they raced again. Or no, they raced on a Sunday, Kevin Harvick won. And then they raced again on Wednesday and Denny Hamlin won at Darlington again. And then after that, we went to the Coke 600 and Brad Keselowski won the Coke 600. And then after that, we went back to Charlotte Motor Speedway again. And then Chase Elliott ended up winning that race. And then we went to Bristol. And once we went to Bristol, then Brad Keselowski won. Then we went back to Atlanta and then Kevin Harvick ended up winning that one. Then we went to Martinsville where Martin Truex won. Then we went to Homestead, where Denny Hamlin was able to take the win, and then we ended up going to Talladega, where Ryan Blaney won. My guy, ended up winning that race. And then after that, we went to Pocono for a Pocono doubleheader for a Saturday and a Sunday race, and then Saturday, Kevin Harvick won, and then Sunday, Denny Hamlin won. And then we went to Indy for the Brickyard 400, where Kevin Harvick once again won. I'm sick and tired of saying Kevin Harvick won and Denny Hamlin won, but you get that on these big jobs. And then after that, we went to Kentucky, where Cole Custer pulled out a shocking victory and ended up beating, like, some of the top three guys. So Cole Custer won that one. And then we went to Texas, where Austin Dillon got his first and only and probably only going to be win of the season. And then after that, we went to Kansas, where Denny Hamlin ended up picking up another win. I think that put him at, like, 4 or 5 in the year. And then we went to New Hampshire. I was at that race, had a great time. Brad Keselowski won. Always good to see BK won. Ended up, you know, chit-chatting with Ryan Blaney after the race, which was super, super cool. And then also after that, we ended up going to Michigan for a doubleheader. Michigan doubleheader, so that was a Saturday and a Sunday race. Saturday, Kevin Harvick won, and then Sunday, guess what? Kevin Harvick won again because he had the exact same car. Who'd have thunk it? And then after that, we went to Daytona for the Daytona road course, where Chase Elliott ended up winning that one. And then after that, we went to Dover for a Dover doubleheader, and on Saturday, Denny Hamlin won the Dover race, and then on Sunday, ha! Kevin Harvick won. It's like they just go back and forth. It's like a game of friggin' tag for these assholes. And then, most recently, we went to Daytona. And that's what we're gonna do today, is we're gonna go to Daytona. So, I haven't done, like, a free race. I've only really done a career, and I've been doing, like, a truck series career. So, we're gonna go race now, and then we're gonna go to the Cup Series, and we are gonna pick up Mr. Where the hell is he? Mr. Slick Bill Byron, as he picked up his first dub of the year at Daytona. So I want the Liberty Mutual car. They don't have it. All right, so they don't have the Liberty Mutual? No. Liberty College? The hell is it? Liberty University? Liberty University, there it is, on the quarter panel. I didn't even see it. So we're gonna run this Exalted car because it looks like Jeff Gordon's, and who doesn't love that? So, all right, so here we go, we're jumping in. All right, so yeah, everybody knows what we do. So we are here, we are in Daytona, and we have got the beautiful Exalta Chevrolet, and you know, we don't fuck around here, so we don't practice, and we don't even qualify, right? We just run right into the race, and we start dead last, and then we see what we can do. So here we go, dead last, all the way to the front. I gotta, like, stretch or something, like this. Oh my god, okay. All right, I haven't raced the Cup Series at Daytona here yet, so let's see how this goes. I mean, it feels good. Daytona is all about drafting. So that's gonna be the big difficult thing here, is working our way up through the pack, through the draft. I kinda wanna come down a little bit low. That's all right, that works there. All right, now we're behind Clint. Oh, look at the big run we're gonna get on Clint. Gotta lift a little bit and I wanna wreck him. He's getting a big run on Jimmy, so I'm going to take him down low. Huge run down the backstretch. We're going to pull up by behind Ross Chastain here. Ooh, getting a little bit of contact from Martin Jurex. lifting a little bit in the corner. We got 14 laps to make it up to the front and hold them off for the win. Doing a lot of coasting because we've got a huge run here. Ooh, hey now. I want to push, but I don't want to wreck. All right, now we're pushing. Big push to Ross Chastain. Come on, Ross, make the move. Make that move, Ross. I'm with you. He doesn't want to do it. Understandable. Oh, God. Hey. All right, we're going to close up on Bubba here. Give Bibba a big push. Big push for the Bubster. Oh, yeah, look at the run Bub just got. Oh, I want to go under him. Oh, God, touched the apron a little bit. That's all right. We held on to it. Two laps. We're halfway through the field. I think this is going to go pretty well. All right, now we're going to come up behind Tyler Reddick. Huge run. So, yeah, William Byron's first big dub of his career, and it came at Daytona. And, I mean, kind of when he needed it. Like, he didn't really need it, but he was in a really tight points battle with Jimmy Johnson and Matt DiBenedetto. Obviously, Matt DiBenedetto and William Byron were both able to go through into the playoffs. Jimmy Johnson, unfortunately, did not. Jimmy Johnson's last season, and he's not even going to make it into the playoffs. I highly doubt he's going to win a race. I mean, this kind of sucks. I've never really been a big fan of Jimmy Johnson, but, you know, over the years when he hasn't won, he's kind of been like the underdog, and who doesn't like an underdog? So, sucks for Jimmy Johnson, but good for William Byron. That's really cool to see him get a win. He's the first other driver to win in the 24 car other than Jeff Gordon, which is pretty crazy. In my opinion, William Byron came up through the ranks a little bit too quick. I think he got the cup ride just a little bit too quickly. Just, I don't think he was ready. Similar to kind of like what happened to Joey Logano when Logano first came around. I didn't get two tires over the yellow line, don't worry. When Logano first came up, he was like 18, and he was awful. Oh my God. I'm okay, I saved it. And he was awful at Joe Gibbs. He just really wasn't good. And, you know, got a couple of wins, but nothing, you know, no consistency. And that's kind of how William Byron has been since he came up to the Cup Series. But him and Chad Kanaugh seem to have maybe found the groove. It's Daytona. It's a super speedway. You know, once you start winning on intermediate tracks, and Matt! I'm going to bump in my mic. Ooh, getting a big run from Blaine here. Now we're up in the top 10, folks. So, yeah, ended up getting his first win. Pretty cool to see. So, we'll see what they can do in the playoffs, I guarantee. He probably gets knocked out round one, but, you know, that happens. All right, work on the outside of Chase. Coming up on Justin Haley, who apparently is nasty in the Xfinity Series. He also won at Daytona this past weekend, which is pretty cool. He's won, like, at Daytona the last couple of times. He even won in a Cup Series ride at Daytona. I don't even want to talk about it because it's stupid. He won by a lightning delay. All right, here we go. Now we're up in the top six. A little bit of apron grab there. So this wheel compared to my old wheel, this wheel is so smooth. So the old wheel was gear driven, had a lot of clunkiness to it, as to where this wheel is, you know, it's the next step above. It's belt driven, so it's just got a lot smoother feel. Feels a lot more realistic. You know, when the car gets loose and clunk around and like toss the wheel out of your hand, this thing will rip the wheel out of my hand if I haven't set up all the way, which I kind of do. You know, it's like 80%. So yeah, just kind of a good feeling wheel, very good purchase. I also have my Formula One wheel, which, you know, in the next couple of days, hopefully we'll see some Formula One videos. Keep an eye out for those. Oy. Ryan Newman winning the race. Obviously not for the holy big push there from Corey LaJoy. 200 miles an hour. On the move on the outside. This is tough. This is a tough spot. Oh, I got him. Oh, I got him to open up. All right, tie. I've got both the Dillon brothers here. I think I'm going to take him. Hey, now. I don't really know who I want to push. I guess tie, because that's where my run's coming from. Oh, I body slam Austin Dillon. Big push from Corey LaJoy. Gonna try and go underneath Ty. Now if I can get up in front of him. And we're in the lead. Obviously, you know, I'm a little bit too far out and I'm gonna get hung out to dry playing out here by myself. Shit. Oh shit. Oh shit. Come on now. Here we go. Here we go, people. Hey! I don't like how that looks. So yeah, NASCAR Heat 5 came out during the Elgato issue hiatus that I was having. NASCAR Heat 5, to me, realistically, game review, the exact same thing as NASCAR Heat 4, if you ask me. Just kind of a reskin. You know, different paint schemes and stuff. Feels the exact same. Absolutely no difference. Motorsports Gaming, Motorsports, you know, whatever they are, the people that make these games. It's 704 Games, I think, is actually the full producer. The engine that they use on these games is good. You can see a real difference in gaming engines, especially when you look at a game like this, and then you look at a game like Dirt Rally 2.0. You know, just the physics, the way the cars look, the way the cars handle, just completely different. So, but, you know, definitely not a bad game. Next year, supposedly, NASCAR will be kind of redoing their NASCAR games. They'll be kind of, they're updating their engine, supposedly, or getting a new engine, which Codemasters, the guys that actually make the Formula One game, the Formula One games and the Dirt series, they're actually selling their engine, and they're upgrading to a new engine next year. So supposedly NASCAR might be actually picking up that engine and using it and kind of upgrading it and running NASCAR on it, which if they do, that would be amazing. So, you know, hopefully that happens, because this NASCAR series, this Heat series, when it first came out, it was garbage. NASCAR Heat Evolution was probably the saddest thing I've ever seen in my entire life. Like, the cars sounded like they were, I mean, NASCAR 06 friggin' Total Team Control was better than the original NASCAR Heat. They've gotten better. You know, the thing, there's certain things in the game that I like that I don't like. I don't like in the car, like, certain noises that you hear. That's why I don't like to be in the car. I also do not get any sense of speed when I'm inside the car. So, I mean, like, I'll kind of brush through them here. So, obviously, you've got outside the car, which is, this is, oh, Jesus Christ, this is horrible. I don't like that at all. You got behind the car, the close chase cam, which is okay. In the car, like, just don't get the sense of speed. And you can hear, I'll be quiet, you can kind of hear the, like, when you go over bumps, it sounds kind of weird. I don't really like that. I mean, obviously the graphics are good. You know, they don't look too bad. I like how you can turn the steering wheel off in this game, because that was the biggest problem with NASCAR Heat 4, was you couldn't turn the steering wheel off when you were inside the car. Obviously, this is the most realistic. However, I just don't feel it is as far as speed goes. Then you have the hood. This is where I usually run, just because I like to get the actual sense of the speed of the car. I just think it feels better. That, and when I'm on the hood, or even down here, like on the bumper, or on the splitter, I guess this would be more, I get a real sense of the direction of the car. If it's getting loose, like when you're here, you can actually kind of feel more where you're rotating. So that's always good to see. Of course, I'm up in the wall now, so we've got two to go. These are not the views I want. These are not the views I want. Oh my god, 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 oh my god. Big run, big run, big run, big push, big push, big push. All right, back to the hood. Oh, yeah, we're getting turned by Austin Dillon. All right, last lap. Also, we got these jabrones to deal with. All right, we got to get Newman. I need to get down low, down low, down low. There we go. Whoa, I don't like it. Hamill was getting loose. No. All right, I didn't go fully below the yellow. Black flags are on, so I wouldn't get black flagged. All right, here we go, boys. Come on. I'm running out of track. Come on, Newman. Making my move. No! Damn it! That's a tough loss. Super speedway losses are always really hard because I could have made my move way earlier and actually won that. And I didn't. Shit! Well, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you stay up to date on all the videos coming out. Obviously, we're kicking things back off. We're going to follow the NASCAR playoffs. First up is Darlington, the Southern 500, coming out this Sunday. Well, not coming out, but happening. It's going to be a good race. First race to kick off the playoffs, so we'll see what the playoff picture looks like after that. As of right now, this is what the top 16 look like. I'll put it up on the screen here. Probably after the first race of the playoffs, I'll put up my predictions of how I think the rounds are going to go, who's going to get eliminated where, and everything like that. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure you stay up to date. Keep an eye out for Formula One videos coming. We're getting back on the Dirt Rally series. We're back. Streams soon. Streams as well. Streams are going to be coming soon. I'm excited about that. Destined to Dominate. Make sure you go Destined to Dominate for any gaming supplements that you're looking to use. All that good stuff to get you focused for the game and get you rocking and rolling. Mine's around here somewhere. I was playing Warzone earlier and I drank it all, so I got to get some more. Triumph chairs. Make sure you use code ZBERRY to get yourself a new Triumph chair. Make your bums nice and cozy. Make sure you use code REAPERS when you go to Destined to Dominate. ZBERRY. Reapers. ZBERRY. Go follow Orlando Reapers over on Twitter. Best team. Best organization in the game right now, son. I'll see you guys in the next one.